Hello, hello, my lovely ladies. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I am going to do a foundation review, a full day wear test. I'm going to try the new foundation from Shiseido, this one. It's the, and I have to read this off the data box. It's the Synchro Skin Radiant Lifting Foundation. That's SPF 30 in here. I have applied it to my face. I have applied one side with a sponge and only using cream products. Didn't powder it down anything. And then the other side, I only used powder products and I applied it with a brush. So we will see like the difference. I'm going to do a full day wear test. This has been on my face for, I think, 1.5 hours right now. And I am going to come back to you at least 7 hour mark. And we're going to see what this foundation has been doing on my face. But I'm also going to show you a few comparison swatches on, like, you know, the shade for this foundation. So if this sounds interesting to you, then please keep on watching, because at the end of the video, you will know if this foundation is for you or no. If this is your first time here, then hi, welcome. My name is Anneke Dis, and on my channel, I want to inspire you to use a little bit of color every day by creating fun, colorful looks, but keeping them a little less loud and a little bit more wearable so you can actually play with color every day. I also try out a lot of new makeup, especially from high-end, luxury high-end. If this sounds like your jam, if this is totally your vibe, then please consider subscribing, because I upload 2 times a week and sometimes I even throw in a bonus video as well. All right, a little bit about this foundation. This is a new foundation from Shiseido. I think it's, I don't know how long it's been out, but I've just recently found out that it's here. So I think a few months, maybe. It is the Synchro Skin Radiant Lifting Foundation. It has SPF 30 in here. And the thing why I really wanted to try this is because it says radiant. The other one, the like self-inventing, self-refreshing, I don't know, the self-refreshing one, I think. I saw some reviews of that foundation and it looked a little too dry and too cakey for my preferences. So when I saw they had a radiant one, I was like, oh, I really want to try this, because the other one was really intriguing. But this one really spoke to me. To really put this foundation through the ringer, I wanted to keep it on full day, but I also wanted to apply it 2 different ways, but I also wanted to powder down one side and not powder down the other side to see what is, you know, preferable for this foundation and for the way I like to wear my foundation. So I have one side, I'm totally looking for the stuff. I have applied this side with my sponge and I only used cream products on my face and I didn't powder it down. The only place I powdered down is under my under eye, because I wanted to set my concealer a little bit. So that is the only thing that is powdered on this side. And on this side, I used a brush and I powdered it down with some RCMA no color powder, and I only used powder products on my face. I put this foundation on around 12. So I'm going to come back at the end of the video, I think around the 7 hour mark, and we're going to see how it behaves. Then something about my skin that is maybe helpful for you, because I have normal skin. It can get a little bit dry sometimes, especially in winter, but I have a very nice skincare routine, so I'm doing good. The only thing that gets a little bit oily is like this. Well, basically my nose and this, like, not even the T-zone, it's just my nose and a little bit around my nose. This foundation has 30 shades. I found my shade match by doing the shade finder or the shade matcher on the, I think it's the US website, but I ordered from the European Belgium website that ships to the Netherlands. I am in the Netherlands. And I must say that shade finder was very accurate, as you will see when I'm applying the foundation. And I paid 50 euros for it. And without further yapping, let's put this baby on my face. Let's try this foundation on my face. I have only put some pore minimizer from Smashbox on my nose, because this is one of my favorite, even I think it's my favorite pore filling primer. I know what it will do to my skin and my foundation, so it's the most easy way for me to see if this is going to act in a certain way. I'm going to put on one side, I'm going to put powder and powder products, and on the other side, I'm just going to use cream products and I'm not going to powder it down. So at the end of the day, we're going to see how it will hold up using different methods. I am not going to cover up the redness of my cheeks, because I want to see the coverage, I want to see what it does. I'm going to take my little palette and I'm going to, ooh, there are all sorts of instructions on the back. It says shake well before use. Well, I think I shook it. Then, twist cap to unlock and lock pump. Okay, so the pump is locked, right? So I have to twist the cap. Ooh. Okay, and then what? While dispense, wipe dispenser after use. That's the only thing you need to do. Okay, I'm going to do like two full pumps, so like a pea size amount, something like this. I think the shade is kind of, I think it's quite accurate. I'm going to start off with my sponge. I'm just going to put a little bit of it on the bud and then just stamp it like so. Wow, the color, look at that. Look at the color match. I just did that with like their shade finder on the website, and this is a perfect match. And I must say, with the sponge, it blends in really easily. It's really easy to blend in. It looks really nice on my nose. I'm going to zoom you in a bit. It looks really nice on my nose, and it blends in beautifully. It has like, it does have a like radiant, glowy finish, but it's not too much. But I've used almost everything, so I'm going to put one pump there. I think that the sponge just sucked a lot of it up, so that is something. Okay, I'm going to use a Zoeva, what's this, 102 brush. I don't like putting on foundation with a brush, so please keep that in mind. But I really want to see what it does for coverage and blending and, you know, stuff like that. I have a feeling though that the coverage on the sponge side, on the beauty blender side where I use my beauty blender, is a little more. It's a little bit more coverage when you use a sponge. That is something to keep in mind. It is lifting a little bit of itself, but not too much. Foundation is on, and I'm going to zoom you in. All right, I've zoomed you in because I want to show you how it is behaving on my forehead. As you can see, I have big grooves on my forehead. And as you can see, they're very pronounced right now. And it's not necessarily because it's settling, but because there's no product in there. So I'm just going to go over that with the sponge on one side and the brush on the other side. That was a little bit weird. So I don't know if that means that I have to powder it down to make sure that doesn't happen, but yeah. Also, my nose, I think, looks really good. This is one of those foundation that works on deeper pores for me. If I put down a pore filling primer and then put down the foundation, it looks really nice. I'm going to put down some concealer and then I will be back and we're going to put some face products on my face. I'm going to powder down the side where I use the brush. I'm going to take a Nabla brush. This is the Nabla cheek shaper brush. And I'm just going to powder it, stamping the powder on, because I don't want to disrupt like the foundation too much. And I always do it like this, so it's not like I'm, you know, cutting this foundation some slack. I'm not. I'm going to powder everything because I want to see what happens. The forehead line thing is happening again. That is not cool. It's like having, you know, when you have special effect makeup and they use that to age you, they try to, you know, emphasize your lines. Well, they should really use this foundation because it's not pretty. And I don't have smile lines, but these are very deep. So I think that you can compare them with smile lines. It's not a good look. It's not, Yeah, it's very soft on this side. And this side, it's still a little bit tacky. But that is because, I think, because of the fact that it's a radiant, like more luminous foundation. All right, I'm back and I have applied the face products as well. So as you can see, the rest. I just finished up my makeup, basically. On this side, I have everything powder. Everything I use will be listed down below in the description box. And on this side, I only used cream products and I didn't powder the foundation. I am really curious what will happen because as I'm looking at my skin right now, this side is already way more radiant. As you can see, it's way more radiant than this side. We will see. I'm going to film another video. I'm going to be back in a few hours. I think it's quarter past one right now. I put this on at around 12. So I'm going to try and leave it on for like 7 hours and then come back and show you what we are dealing with. All right, it's 7 o'clock right now, and this is what I'm looking like right now. So I'm going to zoom you in a little bit. Okay, well, I want to start with these lines. The only thing I can say about these lines is that they are... The foundation on both sides has settled into these lines, and I think they are making my lines on my forehead a little bit worse. I've never seen a foundation doing that. And it's not like, because I powdered this side and I didn't powder this side, it's not like this side is better or this side is better. They're both just as bad, but that's the thing. Then, you can see that my nose is a little bit shiny. I only powdered this side of my nose and I didn't powder this side. And I don't have a feeling that one side is worse than the other. I'm looking a little ragged, I'm sorry. But other than that, I must say, yeah, I'm kind of okay with how it's looking other than that. You can see some shine around here. Once again, both sides. Same amount. This is a little bit shinier than this side, but not by much. If I feel my face, all day I've been slightly touching my face, and this side that I didn't powder down was quite tacky, and this side is just beautifully, like, you know, powdered. Not extremely like cakey feeling, but softer, you know, not tacky anymore. And now I must say that both sides feel equally tacky. Other than that, it's the same. I'm going to zoom you out. Overall, I must say, I really do like the finish and the wear of this foundation. I think I will powder it down because I don't like the feel of that tackiness on my face. I want to be able to touch my face. So that is a little something. But other than that, I kind of like it. It's not my favorite by any means. When I put it on this morning, I thought it was going to be my favorite foundation. But looking at it like in 7 hours... The only thing that is not making this my absolute favorite foundation is these like lines. And I know it's like a small thing, but for me, if you have smile lines and you have these forehead lines and it settles the way it does, then you look quite older. So that is not something I really like. The only thing that I promised you that I would show you is some side-by-side swatches. So I will be having that up after this. Other than that, thank you so much for watching. If you liked what you saw, then please give this video a thumbs up. Let me know down below if you have tried this foundation or if you're going to try it, because I would love to know. Don't forget to subscribe, because I would love to see you in my next one. Bye!